Good morning. Nothing's going on today. I'm not going out, but I do have some things I want to play with, try out. So we are here. I have eye cream on, the Grace and Stella. It's like a brightening one. My sister screenshotted a photo of me and I immediately went and ordered an eye cream. She said I don't need it, but I don't know. When I'm like this, which my kids say it's the my pigeon look, when I'm looking like this, you can see these lines right here. Oh, is that from like bags? Because I don't really have dark circles and I don't really have anything going on out here at the moment. Thank the Lord. But yeah, she screenshotted a photo of me where I'm kind of like this and you can really see right here. So this is supposed to help with like brightness and puffiness. Pigeon face. And I used it last night and this morning. I am going to go in a tiny bit with my moisturizer. Hair's down, freshly washed, air dried it last night. I'm almost out of the mullet stage. So close, so close. The back is still quite longer than the front, but it's coming together. If you're new here, I'm impulsive. I do weird things sometimes. I was trying to give myself a pixie cut like I normally do, as I have done in the past. I kind of forgot how to do it, and it got to a point of no return, so I shaved my head till I only had like this much hair last February. So this is 1 year and a month or two of hair growth. Luckily, it didn't bother me too much being bald, because I have purposely shaved my head before. Why? To get all the hair dye out of my hair. I didn't want to do the whole like slowly cutting out the hair dye, so one other time before COVID I had done the same thing. I just went in and shaved it all off. I might put my hair up, we shall see. So I do want to put my glasses back on for a second. I might throw my hair up in a bun. So what came in? We have the Sephora Favorites Lash Stash To Go. 5 sample size mascaras. Choose your favorite, redeem for a full size. I'm going to assume that the coupon or whatever is on the inside. The amount of times I bought these kits and I didn't redeem it for anything because I didn't know you could. Oh, hey, here it is, right here. So, I will keep this. Samples that are in here, let's see. And these are good size, too. Like, samples, mascaras last a long time. The two that I want to try the most are the Rare Beauty one, because this one's hyped. It's in the shade black. Yep. Let's see what the brush looks like. Okay. Looks like a typical mascara brush. Will I be able to get it at my lashes? The only thing I don't like is this part. There's so much of this part, but not much of that part. So I'm excited to try this one out. And then the Milk makeup. I haven't tried anything by Milk makeup. Kush mascara. This one has 3 milliliters. Huh. Interesting, interesting. So there's 3 milliliters of mascara, milliliters of mascara in here. There's 8.0 in this one. Let's see what this brush looks like. Okay. I think this one's also in black. Then we have the Benefit Roller Lash, which I've used this one before. I like it. I think I said e.l.f. has one that's the same, but it's not e.l.f. I think it's actually, hang on now. I think I said Essence has one that's the same. It isn't Essence. I meant to say e.l.f. e.l.f. has one that comes close to this. This one, the reading's so small. I don't know how much product's in this one. But, yeah. And then here's the brush to this one. This also kind of reminds me of the Tower 28 brush as well. Yes, I'm opening these all. Then there's the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara. Again, I'm going to assume it's black. And this one has 0.13 ounces. It doesn't give milliliters in here. And then here's this one. This one reminds me of the L'Oreal Paradise wand. And then we have the Tartlet Tubing Mascara. This one I don't like. I already know that. I think I already got rid of the one I had. Yeah, I didn't like it. I might see if Grace wants this one or just hold on to it for emergencies, but the brush is fine. I'm just not a fan of tubing mascaras. So we have those. Whatever I do today, I'll probably use the, I think I'm gonna use the Rare Beauty one today. Cause that's the one I've been itching to try the most. So I'll keep this out. I need to put this in a safe spot. Two things that I did go out and get the e.l.f. Liquid Poreless Putty Primer. I'm either going to try this one out today or this one here, the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Perfector 4-in-1 Glow. This says it's a primer, concealer, highlighter, and BB cream all in one. I picked up the shade 00 Fair Light. This here just said it was universal, so I'll probably be using one of those today. Then we have Rare Beauty, the Stay Vulnerable Glossy Lip Balm in Nearly Rose. I'm going to try this on. So I'm going to try them all on. Oops, don't want Luna getting that. Oh, that's pretty. Do I have a little mirror that I can use? I'm just gonna put the garbage in here so it's out of my... Jeez Louise, Luna. So it's out of the way. And we will try this one on. I'm not gonna do a lip liner with it. If I do a lip liner, I'll do that later. I don't smell anything. That's a different applicator. Ooh. Mmm. It's a nice My Lips But Better color, kinda. I might have too much on, even though I only went in once. It feels thick and balmy. What's this called again? I might have to keep the package until it's written down. Stay Vulnerable Glossy Lip Balm. Okay. Bless you.
Thank you.
So yeah, it feels thick. It feels balmy. I like the color. I feel like this is a color where if I, whatever thing I do, thanks for doing the dishes, whatever I do, this would work because it wouldn't take away from whatever eye look or cheek that I do. Ooh, I do got a friend popping up here today. We'll call him George. So, I'm going to wipe this off because I have two more lip colors. Come on, please, that I want to try. And I can show you guys the swatch. This is the Nearly Rose right there. So that's pretty. Then we have two of the Soft Pinch Tinted Lip Oils in Wonder and Hope. So this one is, oh, that looks like the, their blush bottles. So this one's in Wonder. Okay. That might be more my, ooh, that's pretty. This might give like that stained lip. Look. It looks more rosy on my hand. It's a lip oil, so it's supposed to what, dry down? That is pretty. Pretty color. I'm not going to let this one dry down because I want to try the other one as well. But that one was Wonder. And then this one here is Hope. Does it stay glossy, I wonder? Or no? An innovative gel formula that transforms into a lightweight, nourishing oil, leaving lips hydrated with a soft pinch of color and shine. And this one is, what is it? Hope? Yeah. Okay, that one kind of, well, no. I was going to say this one looks more coral pink. But they're all pretty. This feels kind of cooling, or is that just me on my top lip? It feels kind of cooling. Very soft. Did it leave too much of a stain for the other one to show up? Maybe. I'll try and get... most of it off. And then we'll try it. We'll put on Hope. And then I'll probably just leave this one on. Ooh, I see a hair I need to pluck. Yeah, my lips feel... maybe it's the thing I wipe my lips off on. Hopefully it's not an allergic reaction. It kind of looks to me the same as the other one I just used. Anyways, that is those. All very pretty. And those two. All right, let's get into it. What do I want to do? I think I'm kind of intrigued by both of these, honestly. I think I'm going to go... Well, you know what? Maybe I'll do a little of both. I'm going to give this a shake. Because it is my nose that I feel like bothers me for the most part. And then, like, what's the best way for doing this? Just... Just, like, patting it in. I feel like for me, it's only my nose that really showcases that I got pores there. I mean, I'm not poreless because we all have pores. I feel like, do I need a little bit more? Maybe. Probably using too much, but... Feels nice. Okay. I think I am gonna have to throw my hair out of the way. Just so, and if it stays down in my face, I will probably get makeup in my face or in my hair. So this is like, I just gotta what? Okay, I can see it starting to come. Let's see. A little bit. Here we go. Let's get this stuff going. So I think this is an all over thing, right? Is that correct? So, yeah, I kind of... Ooh, I did not grab a sponge. I even want to do my nose because I want to see the power of this thing. It says it's a primer, a BB cream, and a highlighter all in one. Now... Where's my sponge? I'm just gonna go in and use the beauty blender just to, you know, dab it in. It'd be sweet if this gave just the right amount of coverage. As you can see, I'm not using my e.l.f. Halo Glow because I do want to see how this is on its own. I feel like without the e.l.f. Halo Glow, we're not seeing the... I mean, my nose is still shiny. But that's because of my skincare. I feel like on one side, it definitely toned down some redness. A little bit here. It's not a foundation by any means. It does... It literally just says primer, concealer... Highlighter, BB cream. I'm going to do a little bit more on my nose. A little bit more right here. Because I would assume you can build it up a little bit, right? I think the shade is perfect for me. I think I got it in the lightest shade. But again, I go by my neck, right? I don't go by my arms or anything like that. Okay, not bad. I do got something going on right here. I always got something going on, but it's like I split the corner of my, inside my nose, so I'm not bugging with that. There might be a piece of dry... Well, there's cat hair. There might be a piece of dry skin. I feel like it's kind of dark in here. I feel like I see something. I'm gonna pick at it, and then I'm gonna... Make things worse. Okay. I dig it. I can deal with that. Yeah. Good enough coverage for me. So yeah. Although, I feel like the nose does look good. Maybe I need to stop using glowy things on my nose. We will see how that works. All right, where we go from here? Where we go from here? It's like, we are gonna bronze, that's for sure. I think today, man, I need to use this blush. What bronzer do we want to use? I think we're going to use the, if I can remember where I put it, the new makeup by Mario that bronzer. Okay, there's bronzers in there. I don't want those. Oh, I think I see it. Is that the bronzer? Yes. So I do want to use the Makeup by Mario bronzer. I am going to take out the e.l.f. Halo Glow powder just in case. That's all I'm going to take out of there. I'm not going to use... Well, you know what? We'll see when we come to it. I think I'm going to do Soft Glam on my eyes today because it's been a while. That was one of my favorite palettes. Oh! Well, you know what? I'm not going to use Makeup by Mario. We're going to use Fenty. Sorry, fella. Maybe next time. I'm not gonna use that. We're gonna use this Fenty one. Is this open? One sec, guys. Oh no. Okay. That's cool. We're gonna go into the Fenty Beauty Sunstalk'R palette. Yeah. Move this back out of my way for now. What is this? Nope, don't want to use you today. Did I take that out of a drawer? Maybe. Alright. Yeah, I just want to play with some makeup. I was saying before I started this video, because I did start this video and then I stopped it. Because something came up, so I got out. That I'm not going anywhere today, but I do want to play with some makeup. That looks kind of blurry. I'm going to pretty much go into this bronzer right here, which is Inda Sun. No, it's not. I can't read it. Printing so small. Oh, maybe it is. Yeah, Inda Sun. The shade right here. Thank you, glasses, for helping me to see. And we are going to go in with fluffy brush. This is a Real Techniques brush. It is kind of cruddy that these are so small, so you gotta try and be careful that you don't get into the other shades. You know what? I think I need to use a smaller one because I'm just going to use this one because I don't want to get into the other shade beside it. But it does suck because then... like a bigger, fluffier brush just dispenses it nicer. Smaller brushes, and this one's not very fluffy, but I don't have another one that is more fluffy that I can use at the moment that I see. man, I feel like this week is gonna be a week of nerves for Matt. He's currently in a test right now. And he's got, I think tomorrow, does he have any tests tomorrow? No, he doesn't. But Wednesday, he's got tests every day this week. Thursday and Friday. So Thursday is part one of the Red Seal exam. Friday's part two of the Red Seal exam. But Wednesday's the big TQ. He doesn't care if he doesn't pass the Red Seal because he can go do the Red Seal anytime, whenever. What he wants to pass, what we all want him to pass, is that TQ on Wednesday. So again, friends, if you are prayer warriors, pray for my husband, Matt, that he passes his TQ on Wednesday. We already have a plan, you know, things don't work out, but, I mean, I believe he'll pass. But yeah, Wednesday is the biggest, Wednesday's test, that TQ exam. So I feel like this week is a, I mean, even all this weekend he's been studying and he's stressed, he's nervous, and yeah. So you're not going to see a whole lot of color from this bronzer. It's like just been touched by the sun. And it's cool tone, not warm tone. This is like very berry looking. Feels nice. I kind of thought it was going to like just soak right up into my face. All right, cream bronzer. I want to use the Less Beauty. This is in the shade Bubbly. Now, I don't want to put this directly onto my face. I am going to use this brush. I have to glue this one, and I'm just going to dab it on here. To get some pigment in my face. I feel like because I didn't use my e.l.f. Halo Glow or the Say Beauty one, my skin's not looking as glowy and smooth as normal. I mean, my cheek is now looking glowy, but like, for instance, like right here is looking kind of flat, I guess you could say. And I am taking it a little bit to right here. Same thing over here. I might have a little bit more on this side, but that's okay. I can always I feel like sometimes a cream blur. Cream blushes, it's okay to go a little bit ham because sometimes they fade. All right, so I'm gonna leave it there. I am going to fix that right there though. I'm just gonna take a little bit more of this. Just like that. See? It's there. If you're like, why is the lighting different, Tammy? I think it might be because I have a couple of windows open. I'm kind of contemplating putting something dark behind me. And then maybe having a light, like a lamp or something, turned on in the corner. This is, I mean, right here you can see it more. You guys, I feel like you guys see things different too. By the time I post this, it looks different than how it looks to me. So part of me is now thinking I kind of want to go in with a Rare Beauty one over this. Oops. This mirror, is there a sticker on this? I can't even see in that one. Well, you know what? Let's take care of these. Eyebrows. But I do think I'm going to go into the Soft Glam palette today. This does come with a brush, which is, I'll probably end up using the brush. I've always used a brush when I've had this. I think out of all the ABH palettes I've owned, because I've had several, including the Subculture, that one was, I don't know. I had that one, I just didn't like it. I wasn't digging it. Let's peel the sticker off. It's just such a pretty classic palette, right? I mean, you got some like yellows, golds, browns, pop of pink, a mauve, a white, a burgundy, a black. It's, yeah, it's just very, it's soft and pretty. Soft Glam is the perfect name for this. And I'm excited to have it once again, and hopefully I don't do whatever I did with it like the last time. So for eyebrows today, I kind of just want to go in with a brow gel, which is what I'm gonna do. I want to fill them in. You know what? I'm gonna use this e.l.f. brush since I have it. I'm not a fan of the e.l.f. brush or pencil anymore, so I'm gonna use this. This is the e.l.f. Instant Lift Brow Pencil. Has a spoolie on one end. I mean, I still got a good amount of product in this one, but I used to buy this one a lot too. Like, I've owned, I don't know, 20 of these probably at some point. It's just, it's not my, it isn't my go-to. I like the Essence brow ones better. This is in the shade, I don't see a shade on it. I know it's brown. It's like a warm tone color. I do feel like because it's such a thicker pencil, I can definitely get my brows done faster. Sometimes they come out pretty messy though. I probably just hold on to like the spoolie and just go in so that I'm not going so heavy with it. But I do think I want my brows to stick out. I feel like my brows, when my brows are looking nice, it just I feel like it pulls the face together more when the brows are taken care of. Yeah, I got everything. I pretty much got everything I wanted done yesterday. So today, aside from like, I don't know, what am I gonna do? Working out. Yeah, I'm leaving the brows like that. I don't have much to do. Where did I put the cap? There we go. I don't want Luna. So yeah, brows are done. All right. Let's dig in to the ABH palette. I'm going to start out with this shade Tempura. This one right here. Just dip the fluffier side in there. Where'd Luna go? This, I will say this is powdery, but I still like it. I'm just pretty much putting this all over. Okay, just like that. Then I'm gonna go into the shade Dusty Rose right here. Take this up here, kind of like in the crease and above, just to give some color. Go in once more. Oh, there you are, Luna. If I could hear you, but I could not see you. I do got like a red dot up here. It might be because I put the eye cream up there last night. Don't think I was supposed to. Same thing over here. In the crease and above the crease. And now I'm going to take that same shade, Dusty Rose, on the bottom. Was that one of my own hairs? Maybe. I'm just going to lightly put that here. Oh, I think I solved the mystery. I don't know what order videos are going in. I'm just, if I feel like sitting down recording a video, that's what I'm doing, okay? So, I need to wipe my nose for a sec. Yesterday, I recorded a video using Odin, I used a combination of the two Odin dye palettes. And I was talking about Betty Jean or Batty Bean. And I was confusing myself, and then I was thinking there are two separate people. But then I came across, my phone must have been listening, or my TV. I came across Betty Jean, or, darn it, man, now I don't remember, what's her handle on, when she posts her YouTube channels, or her YouTube videos, is her channel Batty Jean or Betty Jean? Anyways, I came across her, and I came to the conclusion, she's both. She goes by Batty Jean and Betty Jean, or am I still incorrect? Anyways, I watched like two or three of her videos yesterday. I subscribed. I like her vibe. I like her vibe. I'm pretty sure she's goes by Betty Jean and Batty Jean. I probably should go figure that out. Anyway, so I have Dusty Rose and I didn't go too dark. Now I'm like, we're going to probably stay on the neutral because of my cheeks. Now we're going to go into, ooh, that's a favorite color of mine. We're going to go into rustic and then we'll probably dip. So we'll go to rustic right here and then we'll probably go into burnt orange. Sorry, that's sienna. We're going to go into rustic and then burnt orange is over here. So I'm just using the smaller. I'm just gonna. I'm using the smaller piece because I don't want to go up too high with this brown. Then I'm gonna flip the brush over and just blend. Same thing. Luna. I can see you. Yeah, hi. Nice to meet you. Don't do what you're thinking about doing. Flip this over. You make a little mess like right here. Don't worry about it. Well, I got like hooded eyes, so sometimes a blob will go there. But you know what I can do? Dip into the lightest shade in here. And I can, whoop, just like that, fix it. I just dipped into that shade, Rustic. Man, I miss having this palette. It's such a simple, basic palette, but it's so good. I just wiped my brush off just so I can, you know, just blend, blend, blend. Now, it's been a while, man. It's been a while. I'm kind of thinking, I don't want to go smoky. I'm going to go into fairy. Which is this one right here. Luna. I'm gonna use my finger. Just like that. Luna! Jeez Louise, I'm not going after you. Screw that, man. Get out of there! Like, you're not gonna come after me. Oh, it's just like that. I'm gonna go back into this. I'm not gonna put nothing on this. I'm just gonna, in the middle, blend so that there's like no weird line. Please do not do that. Guys, I don't wanna go after her, but geez Louise. That's pretty. I feel like it might take away from the cheeks, but you know what? It is what it is. Sometimes I just, you know what? You just gotta go with the flow, go with what you're wanting to do. It would be a huge mistake for you to do that. I have these fake roses up on the opposite wall. So she's currently up on the TV slash dresser, and it's like too far away. I think her plan is to jump from the TV, hopefully she can catch on to the wall, but obviously she can't, and grab the roses, because that's something she's been trying to get after. So I'm just going to keep it like this. It's simple. It's like, what, four shades? Oh, I didn't go into the burnt orange. I mean, I still want to? I'll take the burnt orange because it's one of my favorite colors in here, this one right here. I'll dip into that and run a little bit of that on the lower. Okay, we're going smoky, man. I'm going to go in with another blush, probably not a rare beauty. I don't know, I feel like just playing with makeup this morning. Or I should say this afternoon. Anyways. I like this look. I don't know what you're trying to do, girl. But, you know. You're gonna fall. Yeah, the eyes are definitely becoming the main focus again. Let's put on that Rare Beauty mascara. Hey, you Tammy. Do you want a cat? Yeah. Instantly gets one. You're gonna knock. Oh, you didn't knock it over. Thank you. My thing is, let's see, can I get the odor? Ooh. You know what? Ooh. Look at that, man. I only usually, I'm not one that, like, does a coat, waits a bit, dips back in and does another coat. Look at my, I like it. I think that got every lash. This looks like such a normal mascara brush, though. My eyelashes feel light. They don't feel heavy. Do I ever like how that makes my top lashes look? Don't get too excited, Tammy. Because you gotta do the other eye. Those are still on there, man. Will they wash off, I wonder? Ooh, this is starting to dry now. Yep. There's just a little bit left, softness left. Wow. I don't want to get excited about this mascara, but I wish my eyelashes went up to here, but they don't. They're like fanned out. How are you guys looking? Well, let's see. Let's see. Because we all know this is this side, I sleep on this side, so the lashes on this side are always wonky. How is that fanning out my front lashes? Even my Ilia one, that's my favorite mascara from, like, higher end, is, I mean, it's not higher end, it's not Sephora. It's from Sephora, but, like, not drugstore. That one doesn't make my lashes look like this. I might have to do a side-by-side comparison one of these days, comparing this one with my favorite Ilia. So, I will say, although these eyes over here, it's still wonky, it's still doing a better job than some other mascaras that I've used lately with getting all my lashes to fan out. I mean, this one, this side still looks better, but, like, it got more of these ones. I did get some mascara on my lid. That happens to me no matter what mascara I use. It's the way that I'm applying it because I'm so darn blind. I have to, like, really... And also, because my lashes are naturally, like, they're naturally, like, curled. I don't know if that's why I actually get the mascara on my lid and on my lash line, but I always do. I mean, I'm in... So I'm gonna leave the mascara there. Like I said, I only do one coat. I don't like going in and doing multiple because I have sensitive eyes to begin with. I just like, I mean, yeah, it looks better on this side, but it's still got the ones over here. Okay, okay. Well, I'm looking forward to using this one. All right, what do I want to do? Okay, I'm going to leave the eyes alone. This will be the lip color. I'm going to take my hair down. What hair I have, just to... My hair's not helping any. No. It's gotta go back up. Never mind. Oh, I was gonna say, my hair is almost out of the mullet stage. I'm contemplating going and getting a haircut. We'll see. I need to go in and look at all angles the whole way around my head and see if I just want to leave it. Because I have no hair dye, nothing in my hair. But part of me is kind of like, I should go, I don't know, get it cut. But I feel like the only cut that I could possibly get right now is like a bob or something. And I think I'm over the bob. But I will say, I feel like when my hair is up, I don't know, when my hair is down, I feel like I'm like this, but when my hair... Luna! No, no, no! Sorry, guys. No! She was about to knock my perfumes off the shelf. And then, that would not be cool. I feel like having my hair short lifts everything up, but I will tell you what. I do miss my long hair, so maybe I won't get it cut. Leah talked me out of it. She'll be like, no, Tammy, you'll regret it. I'm debating what I want to see was my, do I need anything else? I'm like, am I blushed enough? I think, should we stop here? I'm like, I need more. I like this lip color. I like the cheeks. I think maybe the eyes. Is the eyes too glam? Is it too smoky? I feel like this is probably, I mean, it's a basic, again, eye look. But I kind of like eye looks like this where, I don't know, it's like a little smoky, but not too dark. It's pretty, but is it too much competing with the lip? Because the lips and the cheeks together is quite pretty. I like it a lot. All right. Well, I said I want to go with a little bit of this e.l.f. setting powder, which I do. I do. I have some. See if I can find that little brush that I use. I think it's this one. Is it this one? I also think I want to try a... I mean, I was contemplating putting a rare beauty blush on over this. Everything feels dry. Nothing's sticky. Let's put a little bit of this right here in the middle. I'm not like overly bronzed or anything. Put a little...
Are we having quesadillas today?
Yeah, well, I took out a thing of chili, so I'm going to heat that up. And then, since nobody touched none of the chicken I made yesterday, I'm going to take that all apart and make quesadillas, whoever wants that. And then whatever's left over from the two can go for lunches tomorrow. Okay. That way, we're not wasting anything. I kind of want to use one of the Fenty highlighters that's there. I'm like, how's my nose looking? I know I got a piece of mascara there. I'll get that. I think I can still see my pores on my nose, which, I mean, I have them. But because I think because I don't have the e.l.f. Halo Glow on my nose, it's not bugging me as much as it probably normally would. Fabulous, darling. Fabulous. I'm like, what am I looking for? The Fenty. There's two highlighters in here. I'm gonna use the lighter one, this one right here. I don't think I've ever used a Fenty highlighter, ever. Looks kind of golden. That might be too. I'm just gonna dab. It's right here. Whatever's left right here. Can you guys see it? Let's see. I can definitely see it. Yeah, I can see it right here. It's nothing, like, too crazy. Alright. If I'm making faces, I can feel migraine starting. They like to come out of nowhere sometimes. Part of me feels like I need a little bit more blush. I'm gonna dip a little bit more into that bronzer. Okay, you want to know what I'm thinking? This looks like a nice, pretty... I mean, do I call this a classic look? This might be what I call a classic Tammy look. Blush is there. It's nice. We'll go look at different lighting. I like this look. Just get these brushes moved out of the way. So here it is at the ring lights. Oh, I wanna see if I can get that piece of. I'm gonna use the spoolie on here. Do I have another one? I don't know. Sometimes, there we go. If you get mascara on your lids, if you don't want to use your brush because you are worried that you might brush away your eyeshadow, use a spoolie and just gently. And just gently go over the spots. So here's ring light. And we will. No ring light. Ring light definitely brightens. Now it's off, off. Ring light definitely brightens everything up. And then we'll go by the window. But I like it. So we're away from the window right here. The blush isn't the blush definitely is toned down now, but I did go over it several times. Hey Luna. So I'm in front of the window right now. Hello, what are you doing? So I've come to inspect again. Lip color, my lips are definitely starting to feel a little bit dry now. The blush, yeah, to me the blush is toned right down. The bronzer is there, but it's, the face stuff's not like poof. And of course, I do like the eye look. And now, away from the window. Yeah. You can see a little bit of the glow of the highlighter. Combination of that and the blush, it's pretty. It's like a barely there. Like, you can tell you got something on, but it's barely there. I like the eye look. I like this look, I think, overall. It's, yeah. This is like a, I would call this Tammy's look. And yeah, the bronzer, it's there, but it's so light. The lip color, see? It's a little bit still comes off, but for the most part, the stickiness is gone and starting to, like I said, feel a little bit dry. All right. Thanks for hanging. Look at that. 1 hour and 1 minute. So, I'm like, what am I even going to say? My head's starting to bug me now. Until next time. I'll see you guys later. Thanks for watching.